Do you know how to use en and dans when you're talking about time? That's exactly what we're talking about in this video. Allez, c'est parti! Bonjour et bienvenue à Coffee Break French. Moi, c'est Marc.
Et moi, c'est Pierre Benoît.
We are back with another video to help you build your knowledge of French. And in this video, we're answering Elizabeth's question, a very good question. Elizabeth wants to know if we can explain how to use en and dans correctly with respect to time. Pierre Benoît, a tricky one.
A tricky one is a very good question, Elizabeth. And I think for those words, we need to look at examples to make it simple.
I agree. Let's take some examples then.
Let's look at two sentences, Marc, and we'll look at the difference between them. Mm-hmm. Tu peux faire ça.
Tu peux faire ça. So you can do that.
Yep. En une heure.
Ah, okay. En une heure. So you can do that in an hour.
Okay. Meaning within an hour.
Yeah. Okay. So that en there is quite important. It means within. So let's just put that in here. Within.
Yeah. Okay. It's, I suppose it's the idea of, you would say, duration, wouldn't you?
Yeah. It will take you an hour to do that. Tu peux faire ça en une heure. However,
tu peux faire ça dans une heure.
Then what you're talking about there is when you're going to start doing it. You can start doing that in an hour's time.
Très bien. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. The difference between the two there.
So in 1 hour's time, you can start to do that. Tu peux faire ça dans une heure. And we're talking about almost scheduling something. Tu peux faire ça dans une heure. In an hour's time, or dans une semaine, in a week's time, you can start doing that. Let's look at another example.
En 3 semaines.
En 3 semaines, so in 3 weeks.
Il devrait être...
Il devrait être...
À Nice. That's nice.
So, en 3 semaines, il devrait être à Nice. So, in 3 weeks, they should be in Nice. I'm imagining, I don't know, the Tour de France or a cycle experience, a cycling holiday or something like that, going from the north to the south of France.
Exactly. And within those 3 weeks, they should reach the town of Nice.
Exactly. Okay, so let's switch this and use dans.
Dans 3 semaines.
Yep. Dans 3 semaines.
Ils seront.
Okay, yeah.
And it makes sense to have a future here. It's a bit different. Ils seront à Nice.
Yeah, so ils seront à Nice. In 3 weeks' time, they will be in Nice. So it's almost like they've calendared or they've put that in their diary. They're going to be in Nice in 3 weeks' time. So then again, we're seeing that in such and such time as opposed to within the time it takes.
C'est ça.
So, en 3 semaines, ils devraient être à Nice. They ought to get to Nice within a period of 3 weeks. Now, we're not saying that those 3 weeks are starting today. En 3 semaines, ils devraient être à Nice. It should take them 3 weeks to get to Nice, whether they start today, whether they start next week, whether they start in a year's time. But in the second example, a red example here, dans 3 semaines, ils seront à Nice. No doubt about it, in 3 weeks' time from today, they will be in Nice.
Yeah, and that shows the slight difference between how you can use en and dans there. That's good.
Exactly. Let's have one more example, Pierre-Romain.
So I'll start with en again. Mm-hmm. Je vais apprendre le turc en 3 jours.
Wow.
Moi, je suis très, très intelligent, Marc.
Je vais apprendre le turc. Turc en... Oui. Oh là là. En 3 jours.
So très bien.
You are going to learn Turkish within 3 days. So it's going to take you 3 days to learn the Turkish language.
Très impressionnant. Bien.
But if you said, je vais apprendre le turc dans 3 jours, je vais commencer à apprendre le turc dans 3 jours.
That means in 3 days, okay, I will start learning Turkish.
Again, you're putting that in your calendar. You're starting your Turkish course in 3 days' time. Je vais apprendre le turc. Je vais commencer à apprendre le turc dans 3 jours. Okay, a quick question, Pierre-Benoît. What about in the past? What happens in the past? Is there still the same contrast?
You would use en in the past.
And the reason for this is because you're no longer talking about scheduling things. You're talking exactly. about the duration of time that it's taken. So, for example, they arrived in Nice within 3 weeks. That would be...
Ils sont arrivés à Nice en trois semaines.
So, ils sont arrivés. So, the cyclists have been cycling for, for 3 weeks. Ils sont arrivés à Nice en... Trois semaines, and it's another en there.
It's that duration. It took them 3 weeks to get there.
Or if you are really a linguistic genius and you learned Turkish in 3 days.
Ah, j'ai appris le turc en trois jours.
Très bien. J'ai appris le turc en trois jours.
3 jours. Très bien.
Again, quite a feat. Okay, hopefully that has helped Elizabeth work out the difference between en and dans with respect to time. Now, if you have a question like Elizabeth, simply get in touch with us. Head over to coffeebreakquestions.com where you can leave your question and we will do our best to include that in a future episode of the show. And of course, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel where you will receive more videos like this to help you with your French. And click the little bell icon that appears, of course, and that way you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. Voilà.
And as always, if you do have an example using en and dans and you want to share it with us, just put it in the comment. You can do that now or dans un jour.
And it won't take you long. You'll have done it within a few minutes.
Ah bon, en quelques minutes, quoi.
En quelques minutes, tout à fait.
Voilà, merci.
Merci à vous. Merci, Elizabeth. Et merci à tout le monde. Au revoir.
Au revoir.